I was so relieved not to be alone that I remember taking her hand, and I didn't say anything to her. I just took her hand. And then we just walked out. Now that must have been towards the end of the war, because there were no coppers to stop us, there were no SS to stop us. We just walked. And I walked with her. We walked in the snow till we came to the hospital. And we went in there, and she went from bed to bed looking around, I still holding her hand. And she found she saw a body, a corpse, a person, a woman who had just probably died recently. And she said, like, she took off my shoes, she put them somewhere. And she said, look, get under this, cover yourself. I'm going to put you next to the corpse, and I'm going to cover you so that nothing is visible, not your feet and not your head, nothing. You are to sit, you are to lie here very quietly, not a word out of you. No matter what happens, no matter what you hear, no matter what happens, I will be the only person who's going to uncover you. Nobody else. And you know, I was a kind of a child, I think most of us were, that the world is law. The word, you know that if you say, if you do the wrong thing, you'll be dead. So I knew whatever she said had to be followed. And I remember lying next to this corpse, hugging the corpse, wishing for a doll. That's all I thought about. I wanted a doll, and it was not even a whole body doll, but I must have seen a doll with just a head, you know, like one of these rubber dolls where it's got just the head and the shoulders, someplace. And that's all I wanted. I wanted this doll that they must have seen somewhere. But I was lying next to the corpse, and very, very tightly, and I must have fallen asleep. I know I didn't budge, and I wasn't scared. I felt completely safe. I was warm, and I felt safe that somewhere my mother was around. And then I heard the boots. The boots walked in. And I heard the word heraus, 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 and shooting. And I heard people getting, I did not see anything. I was completely covered. I heard people getting out of bed, shooting, people being smacked, and people who couldn't get out of bed, they couldn't walk, were shot right there. And I don't know how long it took, but I didn't budge. And then there was silence. And then I smelled smoke or fire. I began to smell something, you know, something is burning. But I didn't get uncovered. I have a feeling I would have burned to death, because my mother said not to get uncovered no matter what. And within no time she came and she uncovered me. She took another corpse, and she also hid the same way I did. And came out of the hospital. I remember I didn't have my shoes on, because I hadn't, and we were sort of, everything, things were burning, and she was holding my hand, and there were no SS around, no Nazi around, nor anything. Now here my memory is very vague, because I thought that we were walking straight to the barbed wires that were still electrified, and I thought that the Russians came within a very short time. From history I learned that it was a week later that the Russians came, but I can't remember how I lived the week when I walked out of the hospital until the Russians came. Somehow to me in my head it was like the time got shorter. And as if the Russians came. But the next thing that's very strong in my mind was standing at the barbed wires, and somebody says, the Russians are coming. And within no time, there were these trucks or whatever were there, and they cut the the electricity. I remember that, and the kissing, and the kissing, and this, and I remember all that, and the jumping, and the food. And then a Russian said he wants to see my number, and he took a movie of many of us with our numbers.